Well, 60.
Right?
Because it's two for 20.
Yeah.
Will be. And. Well, we don't know. At some point, I need to see if there's any other issues.
Oh, thank you.
All right. Think we're good?
Okay, I am good. Do we know for sure anybody's not coming?
Blythe called me, she's not. I don't know about anybody else. We're really missing, oh, I don't know what's saying.
She's a little late the last time.
Yeah, she's.
I call the order 7:06.
Second.
I'm assuming you're ready.
That's okay. When, as long as I got Blythe's name down, I'm ready. Who starts?
That's the thing, I'm back there.
I thought he was gonna get the back in my head.
I'll start. I would like to invite Andy to our meeting. Andy has been hired and accepted the position of director for our new camp. So next meeting is just gonna be Andy here and, no. I'm right, I'm jumping. I'm jumping out the window, Andy. You can take over. I'll give you my book.
So Andy, I do have your Facebook post. It's ready to go.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm gonna do that. If I don't do it tonight, I'll do it tomorrow. So we'll be ready for that.
And then I'll.
For introduction to the world.
Yep. And then I have Jordan's acceptance. We have Brittany's acceptance of hers. I have two more verbal acceptance from our two 16-year-old counselors, Sam Mitchell and Jada.
Sam Mitchell is 16 now?
He is. He is 16 and he's all excited about a job.
Next year Ray is gonna be.
Oh, yeah, no, she's not quite. She's only 14, so we're like a couple years, but. So, and Jada Laughlin is her name and she's a South Berwick girl. So we have two verbals on them, so we need to get paperwork done.
What was that?
Oh, and Izzy. Izzy, we sent her? No. We have a verbal acceptance from Izzy Salvati.
She's 16.
She is almost 19, I believe. She's finishing her freshman year. So right now, we currently have Andy and Brittany. Izzy and Jordan are both over 18, and then we have two 16-year-olds. So we're in that.
Is Izzy a full timer?
Yes.
What was the percentage that we could be at?
We wanted over.
51%.
Right. So we are doing.
So we are.
That's right, 16.
Four over the age of 18.
And two under right now.
So we're good.
Yeah. But however, and that's really where I'm in, yes.
So you said four over 18.
Yeah.
And two under right now.
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Assuming you're over 18.
Yes. I wish I was 18.
No, you don't want it. We have, and I don't know if we want to go right into you, Dee.
Sure.
Because with our early bird registration ending, we got at least 10 more campers that I picked up. So what is our number right now? And I believe our pre-care is at a max.
Did you get in though?
I wrote it down.
Did you say you had more than us?
I gave you the two envelopes that I.
Oh, okay.
That I didn't touch because.
You were the whole reason why.
I checked and I think there's three kids in there.
Total for both envelopes?
Yes.
So we're at 51.
51?
51 kids?
51 campers.
Yeah. How's that?
Can I ask, do we know what the age breakdown, but just approximate, I don't want exact.
I'm so glad you asked.
Dee knows that.
I'm so glad you asked.
She's so honest.
13% are grown under.
Well, I didn't do a percentage, but what I can tell you is, so we've got the three buckets, right? So the first bucket was grades 1 through 3, so it's 19 campers. grades 4 to 5, 11 campers. And grades 6 to 8, we have 13 campers.
Wow.
That was great. I thought that was going to be smaller.
Yeah, you do. That's one of Taylor's like hesitations. Like,
how many kids are there? Yeah, so that's great. Yeah.
And there, and you know what else is going on? We just got, there's more people hearing about this in other towns. We've gotten 3 or 4 Dover people coming our way.
3 Dover, 1 Sumner, and the rest Walter. So pre-care, we're at 17 right now. That's assuming
pre-K?
Life. Pre-care.
Life.
Oh.
Yeah.
Life said, told me tonight, I did ask her that question when she called me. She said that she didn't think she was going to need pre or post.
So we're at 15 for pre-care.
And are we capped now?
We opened that slot for 16, so.
So we have 1 spot.
But we also said at one of our previous meetings that we would waitlist people and see if we got like close to like 22 or 23, then we would open it up. We could waitlist people.
Yeah. Yeah, we're not going to tell them what. It's not now, but.
Well.
Right now we want two. We're planning on paying 2 people for that time.
Keep in mind that we can't take in more money.
Yeah.
So even if we have people waitlisted, we're going to charge them, and then the town gets that money, not us.
Well, I don't think we're going to have.
We're not going to be over budget this year.
No.
We're going to be under budget. The town's going to have to fund us the rest of the budget.
It's what it looks like.
It's based on the numbers.
Well, if we're staying at 50, but if we go to.
We're at 17. For the new registration, just kidding, you were at 17.
Well,
what makes you say that?
Just doing the numbers with salary. You don't have enough campers to cover your salaries.
Right now.
Right now.
But if we, what did we forecast, 90?
We forecasted based on last year's number of 110.
Yeah.
And we're not going to probably get 110 campers again this year.
And you're a rec committee, remember. So your rec committee money doesn't have to just stay in summer rec. With your basketball. You can go to other stuff that you need towards supplies for next year. You know. If we come to that problem, that would be wonderful, and I can hardly wait for that conversation.
But, yeah, let's not
spending money is so much more fun.
Than having to gravel and humbly ask for money.
Right.
Speaking of money, we did get another donation from the police.
Yeah.
Was that
$250?
Yeah.
$250.
I'll talk to you.
Oh,
I will. So,
Lester,
tell about this. So this goes to you.
Yeah, I actually dropped it off.
And
so,
you can let Lester know.
Yes.
That's your responsibility.
Lester.
I get emails now, by the way. We're not doing this right.
You do?
Yeah,
yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
We should add you to the email list
now. It takes about 6 months,
just
to.
Oh. So, you know, I'm going a little. Okay, I'm going backtrack here. Question for you, Dee. Of the 17 pre-care, have they all paid, or are we still waiting on payments for some?
Still waiting on some.
I did have another question. I lost it.
I'm going to registration for Kavanaugh or do Kavanaugh.
That sounds familiar.
That rings a bell.
Yeah.
Okay, just because I might have
I'm pretty sure I did, actually.
Yeah.
And it reminds me, I think I got a t-shirt.
Yes, I did.
Are you excited both girls, or are you just for one girl?
I see one. Mm-hmm. So when I plug in these new, so since we're still on registrations, once I plug in all of this information for this and the ones Kelly just gave me, I'll give you t-shirts information, and I'll give him the money. Okay. I don't think that's what I'm going to tell you guys as far as this is concerned. I just, 22 male total, so now just for just safe.
Interesting.
Yeah. Okay. So let's move on. Let's go to Kathy. I'm gonna go to you.
Okay.
And if you want to talk about community talent or community service for grades 6 through 8.
Well, I have a shelter that wants to come and make ice cream. And she said that she had 30 or more signed up. She led 2 sessions. And she's available any afternoon. So we can pick that.
Does she, with that, do you know, does she bring in all her own stuff? Is that
well, that was a good question. She'll give us a list.
Okay. Exactly, no.
Of what we need to buy. Yep. And then Jeanette, who does the watercolor painting, she's available anytime. And she's so generous. What she's going to do is put in for a vacation day or a half day to do this. She works full time. And so I emailed her yesterday and asked her, so would like an late afternoon be better? Because then she would just have to take like a half a day. I haven't heard back yet. So we can schedule her. We have tours. We're still working on a day and time. And I went around yesterday to the mill. And oh, and then we have the library on, she hasn't gotten back to me of what project she has for the kids to do. I left voicemail and messages on the phone. I mean, emailed her and messages on the library phone, too.
She is interested in having this look at them, so.
Yeah. And she,
has your contact been Sarah? Is
yeah.
That, okay.
And so she said that we're welcome to go to the summer program, and she has projects for the kids to do.
Nice. Okay.
And so then yesterday, I wrote down, I went around to the mill, and wrote down some numbers. I'm going to call tomorrow. There's like a yoga lady that does, it's called a ballet.
I do. And they do. And I've heard of her too. She does a boys class on Thursday nights too. The boys class. But she does have a Facebook or a page.
Yeah.
Megan's teaching that one?
Megan's teaching her husband's at North Crossville.
Yeah.
Interesting.
She has her own studio.
I didn't know that. Lower Mill?
Upper.
Yeah. Our kids went to preschool too.
Well, maybe you should call.
Well, maybe
them.
I
or
should.
Or maybe you should.
Yeah.
And one of the other
yeah,
I think it was Sheldon.
Pretty open.
Oh, you yeah.
Yeah. Anything
seems
other
really
kids.
Open. To
yeah.
Involved and stuff. I wouldn't be surprised.
Oh, that was
just seems
great.
Everything I know about
right?
It, she seems really open to that.
I didn't realize she
taught
yoga.
Can you feel
free
to jump in or ask
questions? Oh, no. Oh, well, she's a ballet. I don't know if she does yoga.
Yeah.
Is that what she said? Oh,
yeah.
The,
yeah,
girl,
I thought she was
ballet,
right? Ballet,
yeah.
Yeah,
she does.
That'd be great.
So are we looking for her to come and do a demonstration or like do like a one-time class?
Could get, you know, for her, could get interested in taking
So more like a demonstration, maybe, is that what you're asking?
Or,
yeah.
Like you said, a once, Tuesday mornings,
like kids
maximum of 10 kids or whatever.
Yeah,
that'd be smart because it helps her out locally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She'd be really be more willing to give us maybe something on a weekly or bi-weekly basis
yeah.
to help.
And we do have another local business coming.
Yes.
Okay,
yeah. So that's what we've been trying to do is we've been shopping around locally
mm-hmm.
to get folks to come and do demonstrations because it's almost like a one hand washes the other situation.
Mm-hmm.
So.
I know couple camps we worked for in the past, we would ask Coley Roser to come down and teach maybe like that 6th or 8th graders something just about money, you know, how to save it and stuff. And they would bring the little cash and violet mascots down. And they'd hang out with the kids.
Oh, yeah.
Play,
Roser
does that. Yeah. They play games with them and stuff. So that could be something to look at in the future.
That's a good one.
Yeah. I'm not tired. Sorry.
So you go be a new child tractor tomorrow?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah.
The full 8 weeks, but it's subject to change. Do you want to do it? It's not up to you, but I'll give it to you.
And then there's, I love this one. I know on my door, she has got with a note. She writes children books and illustrates. And so I think that she'd be interested in telling, teaching kids how to get started writing books.
That would be a great new project.
Or even if she did a story time with her books.
All right.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So her, it's Slugworks is the name of her business.
It's called SWG Works.
I've always referred to it as Slugworks, and I do have a couple of her books and know that she's donated some to the library.
Oh, good.
And her name is something Allison. It's a type Allison Armstrong, I think. And she does wonderful work. Has a couple like children's books that are geared towards the younger kids. Like kindergarten, first grade, like the first 100 days, and like 10 creepy monsters for Halloween, and 10 days of snow, or something like that. The other person you might want to talk to, who's down at the Mills, she's on one of the upper floors, this Tainter Child. She was, for a while, an art teacher at Berwick Academy, and then she had went through a couple of different career changes and went over to where now she's at Community Partners, but she might, she does recycled art. So she takes like materials that would be in the recycling bin and turns them into something new.
Do you know her personally?
I do.
I know her. She seems like she'd be a person.
Thank you, Lori.
Like, that's so funny because I work over there, but I don't. Anyway.
So this.
I'm in them out.
So I'm sensing there's a lot of opportunity to get.
Yeah.
So if this, what do I want to say? There's too many. I mean, that's okay too because you have choices, right?
Right.
So is the idea that during that one and a half hours, 2 hours, you say you can sign up for this, you can sign up for that.
That's what
right.
I would like to see.
And now that we have more of an age, because everyone. Both Michelle and Jeanette were asking age brackets of the children. So do you want me to go on to, I got the donations of the...
the lawn darts and everything.
Yeah. And...
my favorite.
The...
Archeries?
Yeah, that was the other one. Good luck.
I've done that with students before.
Archery?
Yeah.
How many students did you come back with?
All of them.
Good hire, girls. Nice job.
I don't know who would do archery.
Yeah, we're going to scratch that.
Yeah.
So you got all the...
Yeah, the things, and I actually, they're kind of heavy, and I didn't want to lug them into my basement, so I put them in the shipping store. And I swept it out and...
like our shed?
Mm-hmm.
The red shed?
And I'm a little bit I'm surprised that the school hasn't done anything about it because that's a picture of the door.
Yeah, the door is ridiculous.
And like a small child.
Like a what? A
small child.
Oh,
wow.
And as I was talking to actually Blythe today, she actually said that Billy was going to go over there and do a full evaluation of the
this yet, because he said it didn't make sense to start doing something on the roof without, if there was other stuff that needed to be done. So, and he would donate his time. And so he was going to come up with a list of things that we needed to fix the shed.
Okay.
So when he's doing that, I don't know.
Okay.
Oh yeah, we need a kid through that hole.
One of mine could probably fit through that.
Oh, that's
alright.
So.
Yeah, so Billy's going to go. How did you get in the shed? Did you bring your drill with you?
Yeah, Frank.
So, Andy, the shed that we store all stuff in doesn't have a locker or a doorknob or anything.
Perfect.
Drill it shut.
Yeah,
bring your drill.
Yeah.
We're fixing.
That's number, probably number one.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Craig said it came out.
Yeah,
but it's dry in there. You know,
oh, that's
dry.
Good.
That's
a good sign. Did we pull out the ping pong table?
Yeah, it looks good.
Does it look good? Oh, awesome.
And who's going to
there
roll?
We go. I
need
have
like whatever he has left over.
Are they all working?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's
yeah.
Good.
Ma'am. You said you got a new
pool table.
That's good. We could buy paddles for the big ping pong table. I think those all need to be. Right? Did you throw all those away? Yeah. I put my email while we're on here. So I put my email out to my friend who I'm hoping I have not heard back about going on a shopping trip with me. So. Yeah. And I did price out, I think, a volleyball, like a good standing, like it has a thick pole volleyball mat at Dick's, was like $100, I think. So it wasn't as horrible.
I got 20% off the book.
I'm going to get my shopper to go with me, but that was on my, I did reach out, which I've not heard back. Yes, so one of my clients, I was just chit-chatting with, she quilts, and I was like, ooh, how about you come in and quilt? She's like, well, I don't know how many people. She's like, you know what I will do? She's like, how about I come in and do a cake decorating session? And I'm like, okay. And I said, so you would bake all those little cakes and bring in? And that's what I told her. And she's like, yeah, absolutely, I'll bring everything.
Oh, the kids would be on that this evening.
Yeah, I know. And then she wanted to know boys and girls and how, like, kind of, I don't know, I guess, stuff that she would have them do. So she's willing to do that. So, yeah. She's a Rochester person.
Kathy, can I have you make a list of all those possibilities?
Sure.
And next meeting, can I ask you to have maybe the community service projects for weeks 1 and 2?
Sure.
Solidified?
Yeah.
And maybe... for week 2, the All Can special event or events. So the choice is for the kids.
Let me, we do have time for that because that week is short, so I just want to make sure that we're okay.
I think so.
Is that before the July week?
Yeah, so that's only 3 days. So, and one of those days we're swimming, and one of those days is a field trip.
We're still following field trip that week?
Yes, on Friday. That's already booked.
Well, a special event is only like an hour,
oh, okay.
Hour and a half, so it's just one of those things.
Okay.
Maybe we can even get the cake decorator. Maybe have a couple of choices. So like
She has Mondays and Wednesdays off, so I think she was not, so Thursday might not work for her, so we might have to move that around one of the weeks. Do it on a Wednesday or a Monday. So we might have to play with that. Time slot.
Or whatever. I mean,
yeah.
Kathy, I'll leave it to you. You're doing a great job. So.
Because Wednesday's the library day, right? So maybe not as many for lunch.
That first, are we doing that every week then? Mm-hmm. No.
Every week except the 4th of July, because you're spending that week. So.
Right.
I think we took the library out of that week.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Kathy, I was going to reach out. I know we talked about this after the maintenance time. But I'm going to reach out to, I finally got a contact for Arch about possibly getting the kids to go up there to Arch, to the Wetland House. Let's see if they can do something up there for community service.
Yeah.
Well, maybe not for community service, but like a community
taking the kids at Marble to the local test, walk around and look at it.
All right,
they have a bunch of games.
All kind of adventure time.
Oh, they do, they have old fashioned games. Yeah, and I found out, my husband's on the board there, found out.
Yeah, all kind of adventure time could be, you know, I was actually doing that on the trails, part of the very one today, and it actually was pretty good back there.
You said that that was, they were in good shape?
Yeah, I just spoke with Shana, I went back there. Pretty good.
Yes.
It's been clear.
Did I nominate, or did we talk about somebody to take that portion, or the management portion of the week?
What do you want for the camp adventure time?
Well, so we're talking about the first week doing somebody, just doing a walk through the garden trails. Is it the garden trail? Yeah, the garden trail. So it's just if you get out, it'd be like 1 hour.
Yeah, maybe kill an hour.
Because Kathy and I met a couple weeks ago, and I have something like, I have 50 pages worth of activities that I compiled at my job, which are all outdoor sensory activities that I was going to hand over to the new director when we got it.
So that's what it's about, is getting outdoors, it's touring, maybe.
So it's everything from
trails,
an A to Z scavenger hunt, where they have to go out and find something that begins with every letter of the alphabet, to like bowling with ice balls that you make in balloons. So, and he can just go through and pick out the activities he wants, and then maybe Kathy and I could go get the activities and get the materials he needs.
We talked about with the camp adventures that this could be an optional thing. Some of the kids who want just to stay back and play basketball or whatever,
yeah,
can stay back and then split it in half.
Something else you could do is put the counselors to work to see how creative they are. Have them share, I mean, it's their camp too, right? And that's trouble when you try to sell the most counselors out of their camp, so see their greatness. You know, but do it a couple weeks, and if not, they have to come up with every week.
So they can take their respective groups and
figure out. Yeah, I could definitely come up with some activities, but maybe there's 1 week, I put them to the test, okay, do something, plan something, make it structured, and have fun with these kids.
All right, so I nominate Andy to do the off camp. It doesn't have to be in the afternoon, because it gets hot,
yeah.
So it doesn't have to be in the afternoon, it's an outdoor activity. You're in charge of the schedule.
And I'm sorry, you just said something, so this is off track, and maybe this is something for you to decide, I don't know if we've decided, but are the counselors going to have designated groups of kids, like, this is your group?
Yeah,
I would like that, because then it forms more of a relationship between counselor and camper, and a positive one, and at the same time, counselors will be able to know how to like mandate or like look at a certain kid's behavior and know how to get them to de-escalate. We're always switching them up, and Billy's acting in a certain way, and because if we keep changing counselors, we may not know how to handle certain situations. Now, if counselors are too buddy-buddy, sometimes you gotta shuffle the cards, move the
ground. So it's
a good fit, but I think it is smart to have at least one counselor for each group.
Just the way you said that in my mind. Yeah, I'm fine with that.
I think it's smart. I do. Because in the morning, during morning circle, that's when they get really respectful.
Yeah.
And you're talking about whatever's going on today, whatever announcements you need to make.
Yeah.
You can have your counselors make the groups.
And we're going to these groups, of course.
And we did
and it could also be counselor strengths and weaknesses. Maybe one counselor is really good with the older age group, and one other counselor is really good with the 1 to 3rd grade.
And you'll know that.
Yeah.
Now that was something that Brittany asked pretty much everybody that we interviewed, like, because they're a certain age group that you like to work with, and there, it was pretty neat how people, some of them went right to the fifth grade, fifth and sixth grade, and some went right to first and second graders, you know, so.
Yeah, well, I mean, if they have preferences and why I like, you know.
Andy?
Yes.
Would it help if you had their applications to take a look at?
I would love that, yeah.
Can we do that for them?
The counselors?
Counselors?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you should be paid.
Yeah, okay.
Of the people we've already hired?
On that same topic, Jordy, wasn't there something that we had talked about earlier in the previous meeting that one of the under six, under 18 would be paired up with an over 18? So when you're pairing them up, just, did we say that?
Yeah, we just didn't want a head counselor being under 16.
Yeah, I know about that.
So we don't want a 16-year-old in charge of first, second, and third grade of a day by himself.
Yeah.
good ratio.
Enough mindset.
So.
Or even the eighth graders, they're close enough in age.
Right.
That's true. That would create something in any age group that almost doesn't work.
Right.
I remember your question. Lester talked at one of the previous meetings about the mistake in the letter. Like he got off, his daughter got offered the. Did that get changed for the future letters that went out?
Mm-hmm. No, they're all assistant directors.
Oops.
Right, Kathy, are we all set?
Well, there was just one more thing regarding that we're going to do that test. I'll work on getting that going and talking to Miss Wright to see how far she, if she's going to do it this year and how far she brings it. But I'll make sure that it's ready for working.
Okay.
We want to set a date where maybe we can work on getting that set up and fixing the shed. I don't know why I pointed at you, because you keep saying, I'll help.
Well, I think with the shed, so Billy Hammond is heading that up. So he needs to get over there. And you also,
well, I know about
you're
that.
Going with him?
Well, no, I'm not going with him. They emailed me this week. Billy will get a list together of materials that he needs. He volunteered to fix it. It's fixable. He hasn't looked at it yet. I contacted the people in the room. If there's any shingles left over, they're going to give us whatever's left over. With his calculations, he doesn't think it's going to be more than a pallet.
Pallet would be enough. But you do the rest. Then they'll go from there. But first, he has to look at it.
Right.
So we're kind of waiting on Billy.
Okay.
Then we can set up a date. And then we can set up a date with Kathy so that she touches base with.
That's right.
Yeah. Fire department is putting together first aid kits for us.
Awesome.
So you guys all saw that email. We do have to change the dates to Saturday with regard to train CPR. So I'll talk to. But you could probably get tomorrow night to last Monday. I wasn't here last Monday night to be at last Monday.
So we had a couple of our counselors that were already CPR first aid certified, I think.
Yeah, so.
I know Jordan took the babysitting class at the hospital or whatever. But I don't know what
that won't be. That's, yeah, that wouldn't be enough. So you'd have to. Yeah, there's a couple of them, I think, that were already. And at Izzy is CPR certified. That's together, right? CPR first aid is together?
It's together.
Yeah, so if she has one, she has the other, right?
Yep.
Okay. Not all the time, but most likely.
Yeah.
They could just have done, you just
want said CPR.
I mean, you can register to do just one. Yeah. If you sign up for a regular CPR,
no, so she has,
most of the time you're first aid certified.
Yeah, she's good through 2019 with first aid, CPR, and AED. Do you have one of those at the school?
Yes.
Okay.
every school should have, if they don't.
Well,
if they don't.
Yeah.
We just got it.
Well, there's one. Take classes, yeah, so I don't think anybody else, one. There we go, save us a few months. I can make copies with you, Andy, and all guys.
Are Dean need for save and secure?
I got mine last summer.
So there's three.
Yeah. I think Brittany, was Brittany good, remember? Who's Jordan's?
She is gonna get first done again.
So she.
Oh, no, Brittany's on.
Is she also?
No, she needs hers.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you want me to make those copies and all these guys?
Oh, yeah, that would be awesome.
Go over there.
I don't have, Dyson's.
Do you want on the first page?
I don't know. I can skip this.
Do you want me to jump in on what I have?
Sure.
Kathy, are you all set?
Yeah, I'm good.
All right, so, yeah, we'll go to you soon.
Okay. So. Update from last time on donations. The police department came through with the Police Benevolence Association, a $250 donation.
Yay.
For activities and so forth for the kids to offset some of the things we're bringing in. And I received that last Monday night from the police chief.
And so it's for activities or?
Yeah.
Whatever we need.
Yep. Activities and supplies or offsetting, whatever. So to date, what they have through the town offices is $2,039.23 for donations brought in. Were you here last meeting when we got the Victoria Righteous $250 donation? You may have left by then.
Which donation?
There should have been one for $240 that we talked about at the last meeting for scholarships, and then a second one for $250.
Yep, I got that.
So you got two from last time and then the one from this time, and I'll give you this, and you can view it and see if you're missing any of those.
And I did reach out.
No, I have more than that.
Ooh, I thought that was a good thing.
No, that's not a good thing.
So, have you, does that include
how much
t-shirts?
Do you have?
That's separate from t-shirts.
You don't have the pizza sales for $41 on here?
I think that's on this.
What's that one?
Oh, no, that's not on there. Oh, yeah,
those
count.
Yeah, I have it over here.
For some reason.
She put it on in the t-shirt sales.
And then I have $62 that we had for the voter meeting.
That was cash. She was
okay.
That on there?
As long as we're good.
Is it on there?
Not that I'm seeing.
Why did you get pizza?
And then if that's not on here then, sorry, the $41 which we figured out, the $62 which you guys are trying to figure out right now, and then the $250 from the police. Benevolent Association, which obviously is on here.
I'm sorry, so 61 or 62?
62.
All right, I'll contact her. That's
it. Is that good?
Yep. What do you mean? So we should let her know that the 41, needs to be moved. Celia, do you want to do that?
Yeah, because she asked me, I just received an email and she asked me to come in.
That was in their drawer. Is that what you're talking about?
There was cash that was collected.
Yeah.
Is it cash?
Yeah. Oh. Cash and it's $61 plus a dollar of date.
Oh,
yeah.
In the drawer?
Yeah, it's in their drawer. It was in that folder. That blue folder. The voting day. That was the voting day donation where we put it in the bucket.
I think.
Yeah. We
Was it in the envelope?
Yeah.
Stuff with handwritten on it?
Yeah.
It may have been from actual town meeting day, but I could dump at the end of the day.
I don't know, I'll ask her.
No, it's staying here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It never left the building.
So that's the only difference then it appears that we have.
All right, I'll ask her about it. Okay. Just a second.
All right, Jody. There's some backs on there too, but not all.
Okay, so the other thing was, I don't know if everybody saw the forward email from Rollins for an education fund. They are going to be, we have not received their check yet, but they are going to be giving us $600 towards the Doodlebugs coming in on Monday afternoons. Doodlebugs is a glass piece and ceramic painting place. And she comes in, we tentatively have her coming in on Monday afternoons for 4 weeks. And she's going to do like 1 week, she'll do a clay pot with the kids.
Yep.
Then she'll take it back to her studio and fire it.
Yeah.
She'll come back, they'll paint it, then she'll fire that, bring it back. They'll make like a nightlight or a necklace out of glass, different colored glass that flat now. And then she usually brings in a figurine for 1 week that they get to paint that's already pre-casted.
And how much will we figure out what's going to cost?
It depends on the number of kids that participate. It's $45 a head for the 4 weeks.
So given that REF, we were expecting 1,000 from them is what we thought we were going to get. So getting 600 is great, but not what we were expecting. So we might have to not do a 4 week is what I'm thinking.
But we were expecting anything from the police.
No, it's true.
So now we're only down 150.
Right. So.
And my other question is, did you contact Protect Wages?
Yes. So I contacted the Victoria Righteous contact about where she wanted that money to go to, and she said that it didn't advertise it to an activity, to an arts and crafts, and she said, yeah, that sounds great, or bringing in an outside program. She didn't really seem to, so that could also be used. So that's another $250. So that is $1,100 that we have right now towards that Doodlebugs, if we want to do that. So.
Or open it all towards another possible program.
Or what? that being said, I am still going out, leaving letters and donations different places. And one day last week, I took my children into South Berwick, and we walked down the side of the street from South Berwick Pharmacy all the way down to the lawyer's office because the early bird wasn't open. And we left a flyer at every business along that side of the street in South Berwick. So I'm waiting to see if like Nature's Way, South Berwick Pharmacy, or any of those businesses from South Berwick are willing to come in. And I left a flyer with little tags for campers and stuff.
I reached out to my Apple Curtis and my Seymour Electric, and I haven't heard anything back from them. So at this point, I think I'm all done harassing them.
Okay.
So whether they donate or not, I can't guarantee at this point in time.
And I did get over to Atlantic Recycling, and the person, the owner was out. However, he was supposed to be back in, and they're going to let us know. And a couple of the places I've stopped by a couple of times, like Bear Electric, and I think it's Clearwater Pump and Drilling. Nobody ever seems to be there when I stop by. And I also stopped by Rogers Auto Body, and he said he'd be happy to donate, but I haven't heard of it. Yeah.
Yes, yeah, that's the right direction.
Yeah, like South Berwick Pizza, I think it may have just gone right into the circle file.
Yeah.
Other than this.
But didn't you say we had a pizza donation? Did that come through?
We're waiting on
Weeksies
to come through. And there are several in Dover. And I was going to go to, I haven't already been to Janito's, but right next to Janito's is Kendall Pond Pizza.
Yeah.
And then I was at Supa's the other day, which is next to Harvey's Bacon.
Did you go to Papa J's by any chance?
They deliver.
Not yet. But I have more supplies. I'm willing to stop when I go by there.
Okay. Take a look.
So yeah, I've just been going out because all the letters say that we appreciate financial donations by February 1st or by June 1st, wrong month, June 1st, and then that the goods are always welcomed whenever they can donate.
Well, what was Kim's purpose with the garden?
Right.
So did you go to Wentworth also?
I went to Wentworth.
Hanford Shaw's.
Yeah, they had
usually computer. Is Hanford usually pretty good about that, giving out cards and stuff?
I have a question. So it sounds like we're asking donations. Have
yeah.
we ever talked to businesses about, you know, the program I work for at Spalding, we at least once every other month we go to Papa Gino's. Papa Gino's loves our program. If we try to send business their way, we get a 5% kickback towards us. Has that ever been a conversation in the past? I know Papa Gino's as a company, they love doing stuff like that. So maybe if we spoke to them, because you have to hand out flyers, because that we don't get that kickback unless they show that flyer when they go up to the cash register. But you know, it's going to generate business for them. And that, which means they'd be more happy that.
Is that one of those like Wednesday night dinner nights
yeah.
at Papa Gino's that if you go here on this particular
yeah, the
night,
money will go to this
right.
program.
I like that.
Yeah.
yeah. I think Margaritas.
It is.
Done. There's a couple
I did
of
one last place. Year for at Buffalo Wild Wings for my football team.
Yeah.
And
I go ahead and do. Football.
Like
no, not your record. I mean,
okay.
yeah. No, no. I mean, how did you guys do fundraising?
We made about. $100.
Papa G. Oh,
yeah.
Margaritas in Dover is on my list to check out. 99 is on my list to check out in Dover. They
or,
both do a similar. They could be the fly.
Yeah.
And so they would give us the flyer.
Yeah.
I have, and I talked to the town about it. There's a line though. We are because we're a town entity. We are a nonprofit, so
yep.
people can give donations to us, but we are not a 501(c), so we're, like, I've checked into Citizens Bank, because they have a branch here in town, and I've checked into TD Bank, because they have a branch in Dover, and then the one over by Weeks Crossing is actually Rollinsford, too. So I've checked into them, and according to their corporate head website, is that they do not give to town entities or they don't give to municipalities or something. So I don't know if they would give it, but they do fund
yeah.
programs like that.
Yeah, the reason why I ask is just because I just find businesses, like I said, they say we're willing to donate, but then once you put that check in front of them, but if we can try to speak to a couple companies and say, you know, hey, would you be willing to partner up with us? We can drive business your way. We can get kicked back. You know, Spalding, the program workers, nonprofit, and we get that up that Huntington High School's nonprofit, so we get that helped out too. I think it's something worth taking a look into. You know, and if we hit four businesses, and even if we don't make much, at least we hit four different ways of getting money.
Yeah, and I was going to say, so I'll keep looking into it. And Applebee's and IHOP.
Applebee's too, does that too.
And there's an Applebee's in Dover. And Applebee's and IHOP are owned by the same company. So sometimes Applebee's, they do like pancake breakfasts for benefits. I've been looking at that.
Celia.
So.
Job. Get out there.
I've been getting out there trying to make money. And like you're saying, Wheatsey's Pizza. I don't know if you've ever been there.
Yep.
Across from the train station in Dover. he's a Rollinsford resident who's trying to grow up the business for himself, so that he's willing to give us gift cards to get pizza. And I can give him too, but I don't know if that's so, since last time we talked, I've received two more t-shirt orders.
$14.
No, $80.
I just donated $60.
Where are we wearing the t-shirt from?
I have them out in my car. There's a local company down here in the mill called Seacoast Printing, and we will be ordering the shirts from them.
So, these are the ones that we ordered for community members. So, community support shirts.
Before we get too far on, so you have $14 and you have $80.
Our camper shirts will have that same logo with that bright blue.
I had 14 for camper shirts. And you're talking about community support.
Yeah. Oh, here you might have.
Okay. So 14 and 80.
Your counselors will all get those, getting three, I believe, so that they wear them every day.
Have you ordered the council shirts yet?
I do not believe
No, so it's going in
Are
the
they
going
to be the same color as the
They
campers?
Will be, yes.
Do you think they should be a different color?
I think they should be a different color.
Booyah! Thank you. I lost that battle.
There was a money issue with that,
is
basically.
It?
Yeah. So what we had was the camper. Mm-hmm. We have staff and big, humongous letters on the back of the staff. But there was an issue just because of the changing the color really became a cost thing.
Because
just to do
maybe
15.
Next year will be different.
Yeah.
That's right. And honestly, the biggest reason why I like them being different colors is especially when you go on field trips.
Yeah.
Because
this guy is a bright guy.
Keep going. I mean, it's a safety thing. The kids see, but
they could easily find them. Mm-hmm. Yep. I'm with you.
But they're all the same color, so.
And you probably like that even saying staff like this instead of like that. Just saying, I got outvoted there too.
I like it across.
Okay, no longer like that.
Okay. I've never seen it like that. Nor the shot again.
There you go. It wouldn't get mixed up with a different camp.
That was a good solid half an hour.
Our lives that we'll never get back.
Celia, are you all set with donations? Because I actually have a question in the spirit of donations.
Just a minute. The 336 is what I have right now for t-shirt money.
Yeah, that's same.
I don't know if that's the same as what you have for a total.
Nope.
You're going to want to give Celia her t-shirt size. That's Jordan's medium.
Yeah, that's a counselor.
And Andy, what size t-shirt?
Right.
We're recording this. Go ahead. Triple XL.
Yeah. XL.
Okay. Who's second? And I do have sample sizes out in my car if you wanted to see. They tend to run a little bit, so. We keep deferring that. So speaking of donations, do we know how much donation we have for water and snacks and anything like that?
No one's donated anything to that.
Okay.
All right.
Not
yet.
Okay.
You're looking donations for food and water?
Yeah,
snacks,
like bottled water and stuff like that.
So I did get a lead on that too. Somebody suggested we talk to Poland Springs. Poland Springs, I guess, the lady who runs Doodle Bugs, her husband is a mixed martial artist, and he used to get cases of donated water through Poland Springs. And I guess Berwick's water supply was contaminated for a while, and Poland Springs brought cases of water down to their fire station, and anybody who had contaminated water could go to the fire station and pick up a case of water. So there's a possibility you can talk to Poland Springs out of Maine and get donated water.
All right,
back to this. I mean, I have I don't know where you got the numbers from, but I have one day reported to me what numbers they are. So I mean, I can give you that information, but according to the information I've gotten from you guys, it's $382, not $336.
Okay.
Shirt sales.
I'll have to look at home, because that's the sheet that I got from Caroline. And I have my sheet here.
I have a Pepin for $50-some-odd. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that looks like it might be the exact difference. So.
And Pepin, I think, is on there too. You can see a $52 order.
Well, this is a breakdown of them. I thought this was just a note.
She tried to keep them as well as she could. Label them.
And this includes the 80?
That does not include the 80, but it includes 40 for pizza. That's what my notes were. I was subtracting out the pizza and adding $80.
So then we really have 376. Because it includes 40 extra dollars. That's in the wrong pot, but it doesn't include 80. So we have 376.
Okay, so the other thing is t-shirt orders are going in this week. I'll look at this and get for both campers and community shirts. They will need to be, they're going in Friday, so hopefully we can get all the orders in by Thursday and we can let the printer know. I will set up a meeting with Kristen this week to go over it, and I will give her all the numbers I have.
So we keep deferring talking about the extras that we need. So
and we have to talk about that tonight.
Yeah. We should do that
tonight. I think we should take what our numbers are now, and then we'll go 10 more on each size, whatever it is, you know, add 10. 10 for smalls, 10 for mediums, 10 for...
Talking about campers?
Yes.
And can structures.
Yeah.
We pretty much have like a, even across the board,
it
registration
seems like
now,
it.
Assuming that their age and size...
Right. Stays that way.
So... Yeah, maybe even if you have extra shirts for next year, just do 100 shirts.
You should tell C&J they need to donate every year. That wasn't just a once.
By the way, I really like the tagline. I thought that was kind of cool.
So you think the tagline's fun?
I liked it.
I like it, but I would cut. I don't know. The date to me doesn't. I kind of just like help the kids go places.
Yeah, but they want to advertise how long.
Yeah.
I mean, they gave you $1,200. Put the date on there.
That's when I was born.
So.
Sure. Good.
Do you remember that the research size she wanted?
She was the same as Jordan.
But then when she saw him at the last meeting, I wasn't sure if she changed her mind.
No, she wanted.
She was good with medium.
Yeah, I think so.
It has Brittany been added to our email list?
Yes.
That was my question.
All of the folks that have been hired as counselors, are they the other sites?
I only have three sizes written right now down, Andy, Jordan, and Brittany.
Kelly, do you want to do that? Do you want to email them and ask?
Yeah.
And maybe we shouldn't overbuy on those,
list.
So hopefully next year we can change colors.
And each of them will be getting three shirts, so.
Right.
They will have some.
Maybe we just, well, we're at, what, 50-something, so we need we should get seven counselors. We're six
sitting here, 8.5 for house, or people now, so you still need, no matter.
So we have 6.
If anybody else shows, if any, you're already older, so if anybody else shows up, you still need 4 house people.
Right.
Bonnie, John, or Greg, if you should speak to it. Bonnie, John.
One day.
Yeah.
That's not like a first, middle, and last. That's just one name.
Bonnie, John, or Greg.
Greg Zimmerman's the snowman under there.
Greg Zimmerman's the snowman.
Yeah. He's not the one you would normally ask. They have a packet that you can ask for donations. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
And then they fill it out and submit it back and they get back to you within a month. Usually give you gift cards to purchase them for the store.
Oh, okay. Is that
One question. Dan, do you know if the stuff we got over to Target?
I didn't talk to her about that.
Because I was going to go to Home Depot, because I know for Special Olympics, they donate, and I don't know if this is something you're interested in, they donate, like, prepackaged kits to make a birdhouse or a toolbox or something like that.
And then maybe they donate it.
And it's got everything in there except for like a hammer or a screwdriver. So then you could just have a bunch of like kits, and then they could, that could be something that they could do, like woodworking or building it for something.
T-shirts.
And I can go over Home Depot and Middleton Building Supplies, which my kids just should do.
Are we okay with the Andersons and nails and hammers?
That's up to Kelly.
Would you like to hear the story about it?
I'm thinking that's a no.
Chad had Trey in the head with the baseball bat.
Oh yeah,
that was a good
one. Don't play baseball anymore.
Oh yeah.
He has a big lump.
Do we want to hold off until we find out what we need for the shed to go to Home Depot and
We can ask and see if the Home Depot melt and Dolan's place will give us a donation of materials, and if they will, then we can
go. Let's not go to Middleton this week.
Can we?
They're in the middle of personal issues with family.
Okay, who is Middleton?
Middleton Dolan. They're
close.
No, they're open.
Oh.
I'm sure they're open, but the person in charge is dealing with family grief right now, so.
I thought you were saying that.
Yeah, not the best time to ask. Yes. Hold off on the trailer.
What's that, sir?
I think so. Lester. Do you have an expense versus income?
We haven't spent anything more, right?
Not that
I'm aware of either. So we have the discrepancy there that we just mentioned on the shirts for what appears to be $6 difference, if that's really $3.76. So we have a $6 discrepancy there. I don't know, I'll kick in $6. And we'll just have to make sure we get the emails to me or something. So we're still at $235 for expenditures so far for the field trips. And then $68.99.23 for income at this point.
Much more after I get to the break.
Yeah.
Be great.
That's another, I think this was 20 campers or something.
Dan, I think with sports inventory, I asked you to keep an inventory sheet.
Yeah, I had one from the last meeting here, and I put it right here.
Okay.
And this was all the stuff that's upstairs that Kelly checked out.
Yeah.
This was just taking care of the information. Talked about ping pong.
It's
in there right now. I can go over it at some point soon.
can,
add it to the list.
Can we get that out on Google Docs so that this one we can share with them?
Yeah, sure.
It's there, we have to.
Jada would like a medium t-shirt. She's one of the counselors.
That's a trick to get all the books made.
Thank you, so that's the trick.
Send her an email and put it on there.
Yeah, send it to her.
Yeah, I can put it on there.
That's probably easiest.
And there's stuff in my office, there's a big box, so I'll take that one tonight and go through it.
Okay.
Board games and Vikings helmet.
We were gonna get it down, the fire department was gonna donate, right?
Yes, yes, I still have to go up there.
Okay.
But I don't wanna, like I couldn't bring it upstairs yet, so I was kind of waiting to see where I have a place to bring it. But I'm welcome to go up there anytime. One of the teachers that does the extended school program was asking if we're gonna pay gaps with that. Because I guess the kids love playing that last year or in the past years.
What is it?
Do we need the supplies?
He doesn't know anything about football, though, that's the problem. I have a bag full of flags sitting in my car.
There you go.
He might be looking this up with some equipment
for that. Oh, I got tons of footballs and helmets and all that stuff. I have them doing drills.
I got ladders, I got tires, we'll be flipping tires.
You can do any of that.
They're not doing that.
They're not gonna be tired at all.
And, you know, maybe I'll go to the dollar store, they have little min cones, with the small cones, I'll put $2 or $3.
I mean, if you want to save money, I literally have a cone bag of like 100 cones.
Okay,
yeah. I'm gonna have to go check on it.
So I'm gonna let you have it.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great.
Take it.
We're just gonna play football.
Yeah.
Forget about all this.
I have all these kids registered from Farmington doing football drills.
Did we you have to remind me, when did Roxanne say we could actually get into the school and set up?
I
thought they were done on Thursday.
They are done on Thursday, but there's something about moving a classroom or something on. When I went up there to look at the shed, I asked about that. And things were still up in the air, but I don't know who gets in there.
We don't know.
As far as we know. Roxanne, actually, Roxanne just texted me about, did we, and Andy, maybe this is a good thing for you, we talked about for our field trips going to state parks, what Roxanne wants to know, how we all felt about a state park trip to like Wallace Sands Beach, or I believe there's a state park at Hampton.
We got to take the beaches.
Okay. I just wanted to make, I thought we talked about that, so she asked me to just ask everybody, are we just going lakes?
Yeah,
yes.
Seems more contained.
Okay.
I agree with that.
Wallace
not as many people too, so the, you know, just outside threats gets limited by a lot.
Is Wallace Sands coming under the state park bus?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
And so is Genesis, which is...
I like Wallace Sand because that's a very, have you been there yet?
Yeah, well,
it's very
contained
beach. Yeah, because you can't travel like at York Beach. You can't.
Oh yeah.
but okay, if that's
keep it
fine,
to,
keep it to the lakes. Okay, and
yeah.
I'll let her know because she wanted to finish booking the state parks for our field trips.
Okay,
so I will let her know that.
Okay. Does anybody have anything open for?
Do you know what that you forwarded that thing from Suzanne to me about trail mapping? Do you know what that is?
I just forwarded it again.
Yeah, do you know
it's
looking for map of the Scout Williams and the Garden Trail.
Right, and they wanted to know if we wanted to take something like that on. And so I'm sure, I just don't want it to fall off of our radar. Obviously, it's not right now, but just so, that's why I just re-forwarded it, because it fell off to the bottom of my email.
Okay.
And we also have to have the conflict of interest policy procedure signed and brought back. All staff, all appointed, which includes all of you, all of elected officials, everybody who's inside, and my service, and all of that, and it's a staff.
Hey, when I'm on the email distribution list, I'm on it.
There you go.
I did have, did you print one of us, one for all of us?
I did, but I signed them all, mine.
What?
Well, it said the chair should get them all from your office, all your line about getting it.
Whilst my week would have been a little bit better, I would have printed them all off.
Two in the morning, that's like.
So, because that was my intent.
If we're in open forum, the select board is having a dog waste problem, and they. Hey, can we rephrase that?
Sorry, just reflexive.
Oh, the select board was made aware of a dog waste problem.
I like that.
In the downtown area and along the parks, and they are looking at different community groups like the
public grouping.
No.
That drives me crazy when people don't pick up their dog.
Well, the 4-H club that's here in town about manning dog stations, making sure that they get all emptied and stuff. And I suggested that it
Lester
was,
take that.
That it could be
I'm full of.
It could be a conversation of whether we want to do it or not, because we're technically Parks and Rec, and do we want that responsibility or not?
We have dog stations.
I was thinking the same
thing. We don't.
My dog on walk.
They're thinking about putting dogs.
You mean just like the little plastic thing?
The little
waste
things with waste, and that. But they're the select board's concern is that we're already right now overwhelmed with summer camp,
exactly,
and that it would be a large task to make sure that these are all emptied and stuff. So
can I? This is gun. Clarification purposes,
community service.
Is this?
That's what I thought.
Well, but is this bag and then people hucking the bag, or is this the kids are gonna have to pick up?
There's
no bag.
It would all be in a already like built container, and people would put their bags up and put it in a container, and it would just be emptying the container of the bags.
I remember we had. There used to be a trash can down by the boat launch there, and that's not there anymore. It seemed like it was just such a, it just was always full, and you know, it was just such a mess.
So, yeah, this would be a small container, so it would need frequent emptying, but I don't know if it's something we could handle.
For free time, you can do an Earth Day, you know, empty everything out.
And then the previous rec committee, and I didn't know if we wanted to look into this any further, the previous rec committee had talked like 18 months ago, I think, and Jody and I will probably be able to there, that somebody was willing to donate sunscreen dispensers to the town, and they were going to be put up at parks and rec. And then when, and
sunscreen?
Yeah, they're
Audible sanitation things.
I can see people thinking this is in England.
Yeah, what is this?
Do you know what?
Because I wouldn't read the thing. We know that.
Is that through the Campbell Dermatology Team?
It might be.
Because before he passed away, I mean, that was a really huge project that he was doing. I don't know if their office is continuing to do that.
But there had been talk about putting sunscreen stations up in different parks around town. I didn't know if we wanted to pursue that again down the line.
I will contact, because I think I know that that's Campbell Dermatology. That was one of his projects they do, so I will follow up because I go there. I'll look for that. That would be great.
And yeah,
I'm just thinking logistics, but yeah, go for it.
So about the dog stations? I think we have plenty going on right now, that's what I look for.
Although I do like the idea of community service.
Sure.
At one point, I think there was down on Front Street, I want to say, there was a little, we put bags, if we get a bag at least, or but there was a trash can.
But you, this would be like the station to pick up a bag and then have a trash can nearby.
Where is the pilot?
I just let my dog out.
And, but the thing was that, what happens when summer camp ends?
But, yeah, right.
Somebody else is gonna do it. Yeah, so do we want to take it on, or do we just want to let somebody else take it on?
I always carry a bag.
All year and not worry about it.
So why not start off with like signs, like small sign, you know, don't forget to pick up the waste, or you know, something.
And then, hold on, let's do any conversations, hold on.
Yeah.
Okay. If you want to finish, go right ahead.
Yeah.
All right, no, you guys go ahead.
They will be getting signs, local business has agreed to donate signs that say something about please pick up your waste or some kind of sign. I'm not exactly sure when it is doing, I'd be able to speak more to it.
Yeah, pretty much, just there is an ordinance, please pick up your waste. We do have an ordinance, but to enforce it is almost impossible, like the officer has to see it. So, you know, unless people are videotaping it from their windows in their house.
We could start advertising it to like the high school kids at the high school. When I worked for the Rochester Recreation Department, we would have just stacks of volunteer sheets. They grab a sheet, they fill it out, and they say what activity they're volunteering for, and they would go and do that. So if there's kids looking for their college applications or just looking to fit more community service in there, maybe we start advertising, hey, we have plenty of community service jobs that a high school kid can swing by for an hour.
I'll have to check
OSHA.
Pick up dog waste because they're not allowed to throw garbage into a dumpster under the age of 18. So that one I don't know.
So OSHA will not allow a kid under the age of 18?
No.
But just about every kid in this town, probably their chore is to take the trash out.
Correct. When I used to work at Hannaford, I could dump the trash from the little big bin to the big bin, and then somebody else had to carry it out to the back and throw it to the dumpster. Yeah, because you could fall into the compactor. So, I don't know, and same.
But it's okay if we crush
like
an 18-year-old, but a 17-year-old to know now.
You can't be hired at Rope Joe's because they got bagels with them until the age of 16. So,
there's
rules.
Yeah.
So.
That reminds me, Aroma Joe's, their corporate office is in Dover.
Yes.
I know we can't ask drugs, smoking and drinking establishments for donations, but could we go to
Mama
Joe's and ask?
Absolutely, copy through the I can't see it. No, it's there unless you own a an Aroma Joe's.
In which case, do you want to donate?
Yeah.
But if you own an Aroma Joe's and want to donate, that's fine.
So, Jody, can I ask you a question?
It's the other four pages that really have all of you.
Oh.
That's just saying I agree.
Has the town, and now back to the ordinance, has the town done any sort of blast about reminders to pick up your
I know we did last year. I don't know if we did this year. I was not at last week's meeting, and we had discussed it at the meeting before. So I was reading through the minutes, and I don't see any comments about it. So.
Who does like the town newsletters again?
Selma puts the newsletter together. She sends out blasts to everybody. If you want to put information in the newsletter only goes out to with your property tax paperwork. So it goes out twice a year. So
we already did that.
So it's already
out.
It would probably already be out now. Because the letter had to be done, I think, last week or the week before. So the next time it will go up if you don't have time. With the December bill.
All right.
We're not sure that quarterly forecast.
Has it always been a problem, or is this something new?
From what I understand, it's always been a problem.
So I don't live in the middle of town, so I don't know.
So we do address why people are not picking up their garbage.
Well, we have a lot of renters that are through there.
I hear people from Berwick come over.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, so people from other, like, they'll come over and go down the scout lands and not do it. Like, it says to pick up your waste. If you go down and come back, it says it on the way back, but it doesn't say it on the way in.
Oops, too late.
And the other thing is like.
And if you're walking the scout lands, like Andy said, you have a dog, sometimes you let the dog off leash to run further ahead, so you may not always know where they done it. And then the other interesting.
And they're supposed to be leashed.
Right. And the other interesting thing that the select board chair has brought up a couple of times is that the scout lands and that area down there is a boat launch, and so it is over by the Legion, and people let their dogs run free there, and then it becomes a water issue because it leaches into the water at the Salmon Falls River. So, and then that comes into other compliance issues for the EPA. I just thought I'd bring it up as, do we want to look into it or not?
I like the idea of it not having an actual receptacle, but having a place with a little kiosk or whatever people can get.
A bag.
A little baggie, you know, just something. Probably all been there on a dog walk with a dog with a dog, or, you know.
Yeah. Or it's the third time, you know, I bring out my bag.
I know, that's part of it.
So I'd say maybe we work on that after you get right.
Okay. So our next meeting is June 2nd.
Fourth is a Sunday.
That's way off.
Okay.
And do we want to go every other week throughout the summer just to keep tabs and work on the budget?
June 2nd.
Well, June 4th, that's crunch time, isn't it?
That's crunch time. We have the 4th and the 18th.
I think we should probably do the 4th, maybe. Maybe. What's that?
18th is Father's Day, so maybe we need to figure out.
But since every day is Father's Day, really.
A year?
At this point.
Can we do Sundays? Or is there other days?
Yes,
at this point, you and the rest of the staff that are already hired can be working on your own on all these projects. Because you guys got a lot to do. We put what we want done, now it's up to you guys to do it.
Yeah.
But
I think we should meet on the 4th. And maybe that's, we can finalize maybe the CPR and first aid dates.
So we only need one person certified at this point?
Two at least, Jordan and
Brittany. Our under 16s or under 18s both have to, so that's
four.
That's four, right.
Potentially five if you get what's the name references back and decide to go with Andy.
Yeah. So well, we're probably going to have to hire, we have a part-time person that is over 18, but she's available Monday, Friday, so, but she's also available other weeks. I know you, and so we're talking about a job share possibility with her. She has been a substitute teacher at Rollins for grade school, so she knows a lot of the kids. I know that's not ideal. We weren't really looking for part-time people. But she is also, like, we have a conflict with one of our counselors who plays field hockey from Marshwood High School, so the last week of camp, and that other girl can be there that entire week, so I think she would probably be good to have them on staff, and she might be able to be a sub of some sort.
And how many college students we have, because that's something you have to worry about towards the end of the summer.
Nobody is leaving. We already asked them.
Okay.
All the college kids are there until the end.
Okay.
So, yeah. So she was really the only conflict for that last one.
Right now, I mean, the ratio is almost there. We've got 51 campers, and we have six hired. employees were almost at that 8-to-1 ratio.
Yep.
Is that what we wanted to be at, 8-to-1?
Yeah.
So just off of that.
And so it depends how many more campers too we get that last month.
You're good with 8-to-1, right? 8-to-1 ratio.
Definitely. It's 8-to-1 including you though.
That's what I'm getting.
Yeah, me. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And do we have other potential applicants? I mean, I'm thinking, and this is just pulling it out of thin air, 30 more campers, kind of what I'm
thinking. Do you think we'll see that? Do you
I
mean,
think
I'm
that prep. We're going to get a good
at the end.
Yeah.
So that's month 30 divided by 8, so we need 4.
Possibly
more. Do we have any?
We don't. We don't have that many applicants. So I haven't been so
do anything yet.
It's just an idea. Why not hire a little bit extra counselors? But if we don't hit our camper count, we can use those extra counselors as subs rather than keeping them on full time.
But we don't
have
the candidates.
Applicants.
We don't have the applicants.
That has been weird. Not too many people.
I know. I work at high schools. I know tons of high school kids that need jobs.
Yeah, but
well, we have to be
15.
I work at
Spalding too, though. Oh,
no.
That's
not
worse.
No, I'm just kidding.
But
yeah,
I
mean, that's now. But we got to keep
in
mind a 50% ratio, which we're at. What are we at?
So we're looking
4-2 right now.
Yeah, 4-2.
No,
we
have
51%
over 18.
Over 18. Okay. So. So that would be 2 more, which one gentleman is under 18.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I'd say let's not sell ourselves short. Worst case scenario, we can say I'm sorry. So yeah, if you know competent candidates.
Yeah.
My question to you is how many kids have that flexibility? Like I'm sure most of those kids are looking for full-time work, right? So how easy is it to get somebody that says, yeah, I'll be a sub and will be available to sub?
Well, I was just thinking potential applicants.
Right.
Yeah.
We can deal with, hey, you want to be a sub.
Right.
Once we get to that point.
Right.
But
is there one, you keep saying there's another guy that might be, or is
my nephew.
Oh, you mean.
Yeah. And Luke.
Subs may work more than you think, because
high
schoolers and young kids, they're very famous for, oh, I'm sick, can't make it in. So maybe it's, or I need this day off. So I know what you're saying, and it's hard to sell to tell an 18-year-old, hey, you may only work 2 days a week, but I wouldn't be surprised if, you know.
Happy with
2 days
a week.
Yeah.
But some of these kids might have another thing going on.
Exactly. And my family's going on a vacation, sorry I didn't tell you this. Or, I'm not feeling well. Or,
yeah.
You know.
So the other thing we did, just so you're aware, Andy, is we put our deadline for applications for campers to come in on June 12th, which gave us 2 weeks to hire any additional, if we were short-staffed, to hire. And so if we got applicants, we could always say, if we need you, we'll call you during this two-week time.
Mm-hmm.
So that way, if we can get the applicants in, then we have time to interview them and get them on board if we need them. And then the other...
Plenty of companies drag their feet through the interview process if they need to.
Yeah.
You don't have to say, we're going to wait to see if we get applicants, and we're going to review this and get back to you.
Right.
Meanwhile, we're seeing what we get from our students.
Yeah.
My other question was, is in the past, and I don't know if it'll happen this year or not based on our revamping of the program, is that parents would sign their kids up for all 8 weeks because it was like $80 or $100 for the summer.
Mm-hmm.
And then you would get to camp and all the kids would get there and you have 100 registered and you have between 30 and 50 there. So if that happens to you, do you have a problem like sending kids home? Are we going to
send counselors home?
Are we sending counselors home?
Why bother? Just more supervision and just because the other kids...
Yeah, I mean, if it's crazy over, you know, you can send a couple home, but it never hurts to have an extra counselor.
Yeah.
It never hurts.
Because we've been paid for 100 kids, so it's not we don't have the money to pay them.
And speaking of which, I'm not trying to change it, but along the same lines, do we know how Carolyn is handling payroll? Like, how is the staff going to get their hours?
Is that weekly?
Bi-weekly. Doesn't somebody have to go over and sign and pick up their forms and mail them?
I don't know.
You're talking about tax, you'll get the check?
Andy will have to do.
We'll have to work to do just as it is.
I'll schedule them.
We might have to submit hours.
You're gonna.
But yeah, we gotta figure out how he's gonna.
He'll have to submit hours to Caroline, right?
He will submit their time sheets, it's a paper time sheet. It gets put into ADP or whatever company we're using. And the select board signs off, like the chief will sign up his.
Yeah.
He signs off and then the select board signs off.
I think it's every 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
They're working at the library in the summer a little bit, then you just go on a time sheet and then Sarah will just every 2 weeks and just brings it up here and it seems like a pretty easy process.
Alright, so next meeting on the 4th, right, and then I don't know.
I suggest, because the 12th is the last day for camp registration, and then we start on the 26th. I suggest we meet sometime between the 12th and the 26th. And we can decide at the next meeting when we wanna meet.
I'm gone the week of the, I think June 17th through the 20th.
Can we meet the 11th? The 4th and the 11th?
Well, we should probably meet.
Because that's the day before registration.
Right, we should.
Yeah, we're gonna have a pretty solid idea of who's gonna be signing up. You may get one or two.
Yeah, the next morning.
So we've got June 4th.
Maybe we could do a week.
Can we do a Tuesday night?
A day of the week that.
The 13th?
Yeah, Jody?
I'm sorry.
We did our last meeting during, what about you, Andy? How are your weekdays?
Tuesday nights are tough for me, right, up until school's over.
What else is your availability?
I have no availability. I'll tell you right now, between baseball, select board, full-time job.
What about like Saturday night?
And my daughter.
Like it's the 10th or the 11th?
Oh, 10th is not.
Well, there's something wrong with the 11th.
I don't see anything.
I don't have anything on the 11th now.
It's a Sunday, right?
Yeah.
It's a week after the 4th.
We do the 4th and then the 11th. The 4th we meet, we say, all right, we need to tidy up X, Y, and Z, and then we meet the following week and everything's tidied up.
Yeah.
All right, and we should hopefully have everything in numbers wise.
Yeah, because the 11th, we should, like you say, maybe there might be two or three, but.
It should be coming in that week.
So we're meeting on the 4th and the 11th.
Yeah.
The 4th is the tournament sizzler right over here in Summers Road, so if I volunteer that day, I will be exhausted. I'm just gonna go sleep over.
That's okay.
So. Okay, so the 4th and the 11th. Then we're off and running the next week.
Yeah,
so. And we gotta get CPR training in there too.
Yeah.
So maybe we can discuss.
They can't do it weekends, so.
We can't.
I'll talk to.
The fire department.
The fire department can't do it on Saturday. Because my thought was the 10th and the 17th, and they said Saturdays were hard for them.
When is the high school graduation?
Summers Road is the 7th.
Does anybody know March?
Really?
March Wood is like the 9th, maybe the 11th.
I think the guy across the street teaches at Kennedy, and he's late, he's always later. I think Main starts at the later, I think.
They always start after Labor Day or something in their contract.
Schedule CPR and first aid training, like either that 21st, 22nd, 23rd. Because ideally for me, I would like to have like at least training periods with the rest of the counselors and normally have that being right in up at the camp. So it stays fresh, they know the expectations.
When are you done school?
My last day is the 26th and I have to be there.
So would,
I end, but I get out of work at noon that day.
Oh, crap.
And that's a contract thing. I can't get out of that.
Wait, what's the first day of camp?
26.
And you have to work the 26th?
I have to be there the 26th. That's my last day of school.
Oh, I didn't.
The kids leave the 23rd, but I have to stay the 26th.
So, Andy, we didn't know that.
That's a problem.
I could talk to them. I can see if I can get out of it.
Well, I plan on being there all day anyway. I already took the day off from work.
And with Brittany's there with Jody for the morning.
I wanted to make sure things went smoothly.
I work for a different program at the high school. I can talk to my boss. I can try to get out of it.
That would be good.
Let us know as soon as possible, okay?
Yeah, I'm going to see him tomorrow, so I'll talk to him.
And I don't know what they told you, but we scheduled 3 days, right, for training for the staff that we thought you would.
help facilitate.
Of course.
So when would,
so what dates would those be?
So
he was talking about the
21,
so would your that would be evenings then, you're
so
talking.
Yeah.
Right, 21st, 22nd?
We could do 3 days, so you do Saturday the 24th, Friday the 23rd, Thursday the 22nd, right?
And one, could we get one of those as first day CPR, Jody, maybe?
22nd, 23rd, and 24th?
Yeah.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday?
I will ask. 22nd, 23rd, is this availability for the 22nd or the 23rd? Okay. If you, and then your training would probably have to be, is the library open? Because I'm not available those days, those nights.
Yeah, you did that.
The library is open until 5, 10 to 5 on Thursdays.
I'm just trying to think of where they can meet.
Yeah.
So.
When's RGS's last day?
22nd. But you know what? I talked to Sarah about something like this a couple weeks ago. If we let her know, she can make the community room off of the library available.
I have a key.
Okay.
I could just run it by her.
How do you know?
Make that happen.
Oh, you're an employee.
Yes.
Well, these are easy.
I don't want to make
a skeleton key every.
So, and what days were you saying? 22nd? Thursday the 22nd, so Saturday the 24th. If that doesn't work, we can bump it back so it's a Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
Well, I'm just thinking
you're talking Thursday and Friday,
room.
You're talking evenings, right?
Yeah, Saturday you get 10 right in the morning.
And if
right.
you're an employee, then they, I don't know if you'd have to be there then or something.
But yeah, I mean, I could
12
go
hours,
down
12
and
hours.
Let everybody
well,
in.
Well, how many hours would CPR first aid? You almost.
Because I'm off.
You're certified.
I'm,
right?
Sir,
so
I'm already certified.
Have to, so
yes,
yeah, so
you
all day
thing if you've never done
so
it.
So we probably, you probably just be, have to be there for.
So it's an 8-hour thing.
Fourth of it can be ruled.
So
if
yeah,
that's,
one,
if that's
one
how
of those
works
3 days
out.
Should be just the CPR and first
right.
aid, and the other two can be training, getting and preparing.
Well, right. you're talking about after hours, right? Like 5 to 9 or whatever.
Yeah. Something.
Well, for the CPR, it almost has to be, doesn't it? For
right.
the kids, because
right.
I mean, I'm already certified, so. It's whatever works best for the rest of the
but if
group.
It's 8 hours, then that would be 4 hours one night, 4 hours the next night.
8 hours for the certification?
No, it's not that. Like, I did it
well.
Mine,
hours
when I did mine, it's,
my
normally it takes about
4 hours.
Yeah, it wasn't 8 hours.
So
no.
Hopefully it's only 4 hours, I guess, if we can find that out. But
we,
then you can do
Friday, Saturday training, if we can do it.
Yeah, I mean, I think the most important thing is finding out how long that CPR certification course takes. I've never heard of an 8-hour course before.
Welcome to being a provider.
So what if
my
class?
It's probably different. I don't know.
They will.
I've only taken one.
Nobody really doesn't pass.
Nobody really doesn't
you
pass. Unless you pick the body up and just like slam it.
Keep doing it till you do it right.
Yeah, essentially.
I would be willing those days. I'm off. I'm out of school by that time. I'd be willing to, if we want to use the library, I could go down and hang out.
We'll write that down.
You know.
I got to start training possibly at the library.
That's a perfect spot. I mean, there's no
so, Dan, do you want to check the library or CRE
done
check
the
library?
If he's got a key and he's willing to do it, I'm passing it off to Dan.
Perfect.
And
I'll
just
check the
I'll
library.
And when?
I wrote Dan, we'll facilitate.
When will we be able to get into the school?
Maybe Friday. I mean, we are not getting in before Friday.
Well, I'm almost thinking if we did 22nd as a Thursday, if that was at the library, they did a certification, and then 23rd is that Friday
at
the school, meet, talk, start setting stuff up,
yeah,
that kind of thing.
Perfect.
And then
24th. Do we get in the school on the 24th?
Well, that's what we need to verify.
You have
didn't,
to.
Roxanne, I think Roxanne said we could.
You have
right.
To.
So
to.
Let's.
I'm assuming the 24th and the 25th were going to be.
I think it's on the training, like any window.
I need to tell her about the late.
For like
right
the
now.
Non-CPR day,
whatever.
The Friday will probably be like a 5 to 9. 5 to 8. Yeah, 5 to 9.
And we need to have verification.
Just so I can contact.
Yeah, and then that Saturday maybe like 8 to noon or something like that.
Okay.
All right. So.
I'm wondering if you probably couldn't get in the call on Saturday. Although I got a key.
Well, the fire department might do it right at the fire station.
That's true too.
Maybe you want to do it there, they're bringing them or whatever. So we good? Anything else?
Yeah.
What about taking inventory of arts and crafts things and stuff that we need?
Didn't we decide in the last meeting that there was no inventory? I thought that's weird.
We thought it was all like, whatever you collected. And I'm not expecting to use any of the schools.
I think we need to buy.
So we need some of this donation money.
We should take some of that money and go to Target or Walmart and buy a bunch of arts and crafts supplies.
Yes, I think that definitely needs to be done.
Yeah.
And a nice list for the parents.
Yes.
Hey, send me plates and.
I think if there's a project that we schedule in or something, we can ask. Like the t-shirts, we're supposed to be doing tie-dyes, so
bring
a white t-shirt. Yep.
And every business I've been to, and I think Kathy did the same thing, when we dropped off the postcard with, we would like, and it has like all of the snacks, water, and arts and crafts supplies, Play-Doh, stuff like that. So. We may get
reposted on your Raleigh books.
Yeah. And I was thinking if we don't, I'm going to continue going out to different businesses over the next week or so, and then I'm going to go back to the businesses I've already gone to and see if they had made a decision about donating or not.
Can we have art supply donations dropped off here at the town hall?
Yep.
Okay.
I don't know how you can move in your office anymore.
My office is great. I have planning stuff on the desk and rec stuff on the chair.
All right.
That's I never use it. I'm always in here.
It's a storage room.
Yep. All right. Motion to adjourn.
Second.
You can't motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
There you go.
I thought I could do that.
No.